Hello, folks. Just squeezing in a little bit of sand painting time before my wonderful friend and client gets here. She's having a Uber cab ride from Ottawa Airport, coming from the States. So I'm getting in just a little bit of sand time before I tattoo for 3 days. And then my aim is to try and get, and this is Raven's suggestion, that for those 3 days of tattooing that I try and finish this in between. So that then my client Allison could be the person to sweep it away. I always inflict these horrible things onto friends. Because I can't do it. No, I can't, but just joking. Yeah, just having fun. Listening to music and building my little snowbanks here. Little sandbanks.
Positing each little dot, each little particle.
I was listening to stuff about the dot and Kabbalistic symbolism the other day, and it's like the beginning, where everything sprouts out from. A singular reality, and then existence comes from that. Dot, I think it was like period, I can't remember how to pronounce it. It's sort of where the word period comes from. Period or something, yod. And another word that sounds like dot, but it's spelled differently. It was kind of interesting. So it's always fun hearing different cultures' symbolism on the sacredness of the dot. Of course, in Hindu symbolism, there is the bindu, which is what the very center of this is considered. And I'm guessing that's where the bindi that a lot of Hindu women wear on their forehead comes from as well. It's that sacred dot. I won't start wearing one. A little too new agey, but dot definitely is a sacred symbol for me. Last night I got lost in revelry while I was working on this, thinking about my hobbit house that I want to build out in the forest for doing my deer bone hand poke tattoo sessions for people. They're complete with wood stove, maybe even some, have the wood stove so it heats water and stuff. Might be quite civilized and things, a little village spot. And I might gear it so that it can be rented, you know, for a week, for a month, for whatever people want to just go and have a nice retreat. I think that would be very cool. So we'll see how we set it up. Eventually, I'm pretty sure I'm going to want to do at least one more. To the eventual goal, maybe of having a little earth mound forest village. And that could be really fun on so many levels. Events of some, all kinds of things come to mind, where people could all be staying in, each in their own little hobbit house in the forest. I think that could be pretty magical. See how all of that unfolds. I think once I get it down working well, then the next one would be worth maybe doing as a workshop or something for people that would want to create their own on a little piece of land. Right now I'm finding that the perfect music to play while I'm doing this is a group called Ramasutra, starting with an R. Oh, you run out of places to put rest your palm with this kind of work. I'm thinking of making a little resting thing, like a piece of wood, thin, with two little resting spots made out of, like, with either rubber or felt, that I could carefully place across somewhere that I could then... To see what I did?
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that. Major reconstruction there.
It has an interesting quality to it.
Yes.
So it looks
but
like...
But I will indulge for a very short while and then change it very quickly. Not my kind of indulgence.
No.
My indulgence is to resist the urge to get pulled into an annoyance. I think I would get pulled into it if it was a massive area.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, even this amount, this is a, like, believe it or not, this is a lot of work. If it was just that blue and yellow, but this stuff here, like, it literally all has to be, I will show you. This is just to give you an idea of the...
Well, I don't think you need to.
You don't know what reality is in this area, Riff. Honestly, do not. And you must give that up to me. Because I'm doing what I know, based on my experience, is the best way to clear this up. Not bad though, that's the first time I've had that much smudged. So once so far on my second mandala, that's not too bad. That's how I have to look at it. It could have been worse, could have been many more times. This is a blessing. Maybe in disguise, but it could easily be a blessing. So now, see, if I try and rebuild that the way it was, it would have just piled up and got worse and worse. I would have got more frustrated and more frustrated. So I just knew it's time to amputate. But this is an amputation that can be rebuilt. Some degree, sometimes seeing to be just moved a little bit like that to clean up a line. Sometimes it'll backfire and it makes it worse. Too excited there. I was just thinking that I should keep this sand to go in with the other at the end. Okay, I will leave that there until I find the little container that I keep my waste pile.
Your compost pile.
Yes. But this is all energy, neither created nor destroyed, so this goes into the pile to go into the waterfall at the end. So now, this will be fun. I've created an opportunity, a great opportunity. Maybe I'll use up whatever blue I have left in here first to demonstrate a little repair. That's actually kind of fun for me to see too, because I've never had to do it before. But let's do our little blues. Thinking to myself, one of my issues that I'm going through with all of this is that, say, a dark colored sand in one of these tubes, chalk burrs, and then I change, no matter how much I blow on it, it's going to leave little bits of dust. I don't know if it's like static or what it is, but dust coats the inside and then will to some degree influence the other color, no matter how much I try wiping it out. And I can't wet it and wash it because then it's, it takes a long time to dry, and then it tends to oxidize, I guess is the word. So I'm thinking really what I need is one of those little aerosol cans or an electric air hose.
Air compressor.
Compressor, yeah. So that, my little compressor for airbrushing or something to have it up here so I can just spray out my...
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Thing once in a while. I think it should work. Or at least it'll work better than what I'm doing. basically just moving this line around till I get it to fit a nice arc with the rest of the circle.
Circles are a challenge to learn, even how to tattoo a good circle.
Oh, yes. Vocabulary to replace even things like I was just thinking fix.
Mm-hmm.
Still sort of gives that sense that it's something that's broken.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe by creating a vocabulary, at least for sand painting,
yeah,
where you don't use certain descriptions of something broken or wrecking something. Oh, Gracie, be quiet.
Or maybe your client's here.
Oh, I was going to say that we should phone him and say not to try and drive into the driveway or else he'll be stuck.
Oh.
For sure. I didn't think about that until... I did think about it, but I didn't mention it.
All right, I'm going to go check the door.
Yeah, and then we'll come back to this.
Okay.
Okay, guys, we're just going to go and make sure that my client gets here in one piece because we haven't plowed the driveway yet. We're without a snowplow guy. So we're just going to warn the guy, the driver, to not try and get into the lane with his car.